In this video, I'm going to show you how to connect multiple different streaming chat rooms into one easy-to-use program. This will include Twitch, YouTube Gaming, Hitbox, BeamPro, and more. We're also going to add this chat into our OBS Studio for our viewers to see. Let's get right into it. Arguably, the most important part about being a streamer is interacting with your viewers in some form. In my latest video, I showed you how to stream to multiple platforms at the same time. So let's take time and see how to combine all these chat rooms into one place so that we can easily interact with viewers across multiple platforms. To start, we can head to restream.io/chat. The link will be in the description. We can see a brief preview of how chat will look, where it shows the icon for the platform our viewers are chatting on, their nickname, a timestamp, and the message. By the way, all of this can be customized a bit as well. Let's go ahead and download and install this program just like any other. Before we actually launch this app, I'm going to go back to restream.io and log into my account. Once I'm in, I'm going to make sure the channels I want to connect and chat are added inside of my Restream dashboard. If you need more help on how to do this, make sure to watch my last video about setting up your account. Anyways, let's go ahead and launch the program and log into our Restream account. You might not see much here, but let me walk you through the interface. First, the top left, we'll see an icon that shows how many services we connect to, and then we'll also see how many people are in all the rooms. If we click this area on the top left, it will show and hide our services, as well as give us a better breakdown of what all is connected. You can also clear history in the bottom left. You'll notice that some services show read-only. This is because the program is not able to send chat messages to these services. However, the other ones that show online can have messages sent from our account to the chat rooms, meaning we can basically communicate with all these different chat rooms through the Restream program. I'll hide this section and show you more about how we can send messages. First, I'll type a message to myself in Twitch and Hitbox chat to show you that they're connected. Again, you'll see the icons that represent where the message is from. Already, I think this program is pretty awesome, but there's much more. At the bottom, there's a drop-down and an area that says Write to Chat. This is where we can enter our commands to various platforms. If you click the drop-down, you'll also be shown different channels that you can specify your messages to go to. This will also filter your chat messages for each service in case you want to check out what's happening on just Twitch, YouTube, etc. Leaving the drop-down on all chat option will attempt to broadcast your message to any services that are not marked read-only. So far, you'll see how easy it is to communicate with various users, but it might be confusing to some of them if you're streaming in one place and talking to another. So let's go into the settings and I'll show you in just a second how to add this chat window inside of OBS Studio a couple of different ways. And I do want to mention that there is an update coming out very soon, and as soon as that hits, I'll be making a video about it of how to add this into OBS Studio another way. Anyways, first, we can check out the general settings. We can see some options here, but I want to make sure that Force Chat Auto Scroll is enabled. Next, we have Chat Accounts. This allows us to double check which accounts are connected. As I mentioned, it will sync with our settings in our Restream dashboard. But if you're having issues with the chat room, you can always try to reconnect here. Chat filters allows you to specify any words you'd like not to be shown in either the app or the web UI. So all that you need to do is put the words that you'd like to have filtered and have them separated by a comma, and then enable both of these options. One small quirk that I notice about the program is that it is space sensitive, meaning that after the comma, don't use a space or it might not filter out the words that you put. In the window section, we can disable always on top if we like, as well as enable window background transparency. You can play around with these sliders to get a look that you prefer. For the fonts, you can specify sizes and visibility of some of the items. So hopefully they add a little bit more to this in the near future, as I'd love to kind of customize my font colors and even font family here. Next is notifications. Basically, we can set a sound that's played when we have a new message, or a sound that plays when our nickname is mentioned. I think it could be a bit annoying for every message to have a sound, but I could definitely see some use for the second option here, especially in busier chats. With all those set up, we're finally at the sections that allow us to add this chat system into OBS Studio. There's two different ways to do it right now, and they're very easy. Let's start with the easiest way, save chat to image. After you enable the option, we can select where the image is saved to. You can see that this will be in my pictures folder with the name restreamchat.png. This seems fine to me, so I'll hit save and open up OBS Studio. In OBS, I'll simply add in an image source and browse to where the image is saved. I'll select it, and that's pretty much it. If you don't see anything yet, it's because a new image only generates when a chat message is shown. So you might have to have an image generated since you just installed the app. Go ahead and type something into one of your chat rooms and you should see an image appear. Feel free to use OBS Studio filters and cropping to further customize this as needed. I also recommend typing out a lot of lines slowly to see how everything looks and reacts. Remember, you can change the font size and window appearance in the settings as well. The second way we can add this into OBS Studio is through a web server. If this is enabled, you can go to the address localhost colon and then the port number that you have entered, in this case 8080. You can change the port number here if you need to, but hopefully this doesn't cause you any issues. Also, you might get a pop-up that says something about allowing it to run on your network, so just hit OK or allow for that and you'll be able to move on. So anyways, if I go to localhost colon 8080 in my browser, I should see some chat history since I had this enabled from the start. If yours wasn't enabled, you'll need to type a few messages to have something shown. Let's go ahead and copy this URL and go back into OBS Studio. I'm going to go ahead and add in a browser source and give it a width and a height and then paste in the localhost URL that we just copied to add in our chat inside of OBS Studio. If you know CSS, you can even override the CSS in the source properties to further customize the appearance. This is my preferred method since I do know CSS, but I still think the image source is pretty great. Okay, let's go through the last options of the settings as we finish up this video, which is to save a chat to file. Basically, this option allows you to save your chat history to text files. You can simply enable it, select where the files are going to save, and then if you want to generate daily logs and general logs. Basically, this will save different chat files for you that contains everything that people say in all of your different chat rooms. The Restream account tab only allows us to log out, and the About tab shows us what version we're using. With that, you should know everything that you need to properly communicate to your viewers across multiple different streaming platforms. I'm a huge fan of this program and Restream in general, and I can't wait to see how it improves in the future. As I mentioned, according to Restream's Twitter, there's going to be a new way to add chat into OBS Studio soon, so keep an eye out for that video, which will walk you through the new process. Anyways, if you have any questions about this video, please leave them in the comments below. If you liked the video, give it a like, and if you'd like to see more great streaming and video game related content, make sure to subscribe to Nerd or Die. Thanks for watching.